So thank you guys for joining me.
Thank you.
Really excited. So I think to kick us off, it would be great to hear a brief overview from both of you and your perspectives on artificial intelligence and underwriting and what it means to your respective companies.
You want to go first?
All right, I'll go first. So I think if you look back at the history of financial services, there have been a couple of really material inflection points. You know, obviously the creation of money was an inflection point, the creation of fiat currency was an inflection point, the creation of FICO was an inflection point. And I think people are going to look back at the next kind of 10 years in the future as the creation of machine learning, driven primarily by the fact that computation is now free and infinite, storage is free and infinite, and bandwidth is free and infinite. Those three drivers, I think, have led to the creation of a bunch of ML tools that are going to transform the way banks run, the way banks lend money, the way banks collect money. So I think in 20 years, this will be the time that people will look back to wishing they'd been part of the story.
And I would just build off that to say, you know, we've always had a tremendous amount of data. We have lots of data. And I think the real question is, how do you make use of that data in real-time decisioning, whether that's to approve a credit, authenticate a customer to make sure we're actually lending to who we say we think we're lending to, and protecting against fraud. So I think what Douglas said, having the capacity from a technology perspective to monetize that data in such a way to really use it to make those decisions quicker, faster, immediate, is really the big win I think all of us are having as we think about AI and machine learning and models going forward.
Right.